Today's Marriage Money Gem deals with debt. Top attorney Gemma Allen joins us now for her money lessons. Thanks for being with us. Good to see you there, Gemma.
Good to see you, Angie.
Is it true that most breakups involve dividing not only assets, but also dividing up debt?
Absolutely right, Angie. And it's a sad fact that there's not only regrets, but division of debts. Even the most well-managed couple always has some debt when you think about it. There's usually a mortgage, a lease, perhaps a car loan. Depending on the age of the people, there can be lingering student debt from their own lives or looming student debt for their kids.
How can a couple handle this situation? What do you think? And is there actually a lesson here for all couples, especially those who want to stay together and don't want debt to become an issue in their marriage?
There is a lesson, Angie, and that is always try and approach debt logically and amicably. If you can do that, you may not even need a divorce. But the truth is, when you look at it, if there's certain debt that's tied to an asset, for example, and if you are separating, then the person who gets the asset will likely get the debt that goes with it, and that only makes sense. Think about a car loan. If you're talking about student loans that got you to your education, but you took those loans out before you were married, the debt will follow you, but so will the benefit of the education follow you. See, other debts, if there's a house and you are actually divorcing, frequently the house has to be sold, and that's hard. But if one person can afford to buy the other one out, that's another way to approach it. And they only have to buy out the equity. In other words, the difference between the value of the house and the debt. So if you could buy the other party out and then refinance, that's a solution. So debt is never comfortable, but no matter what, it shouldn't be a subject for fighting.
What tends to happen with credit card debt?
So what happens is, again, if it's a credit card that's in one name, but it was spent for family purposes, you both owe that debt. So don't think that just because it's in someone else's name, they can carry that debt away. It's not necessarily true. On the other hand, if one person had a credit card and they were spending it on an addiction or an affair, that money will primarily get allocated to them as a debt. These are tricky waters, but you can get through them. And the fact is that if it's a joint credit card, once you figure out how to allocate the debt, be sure to close that credit card. And be sure when you close it that there's no lingering charges or interest payments somehow that are out there. Call the representative for the account. Explain what happened so that the divorce doesn't ding your debt or your credit rating. And then try to move on with your lives with separate credit cards, each in your own name. Happy days, maybe there again.
Well, thank you as always, Gemma, and we will see you next week.
You're very welcome, Angie. It's a pleasure.
More Business First AM. Check us out on social media. We're on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. And go to businessfirstam.com for where to see our show on TV.